Hello, you are watching Violin and Viola TV, and my name is Zlatan Brouwer. In this episode, we are going to answer a question from one of our viewers, Taryn. And first, a little disclaimer before I go talking into things you should or shouldn't do with arthritis or fibromyalgia. I'm a violin teacher and I'm not a doctor, okay? So if your body tells you otherwise, if your doctor tells you otherwise, then just try to find out what's good for you, but I can't give you here in this general video very specific advice for what is good for your situation. So, end of disclaimer. Taryn writes, he wants to know, hi Zlatan, I've been watching your videos on YouTube and have found them very helpful. I got my violin back in December and have been playing for about 4 weeks now. Do you have any tips or advice on playing comfortably for people with arthritis? I've heard many people say that your bowing hand should feel relaxed and not feel tight or strained. But with arthritis in my wrist, it's hard to pinpoint whether the pain is coming from my playing, doing something incorrectly perhaps, or if it's another factor, which can even be the weather. I want to make sure that I'm not developing any bad habits early and want to catch them before I get too set into my ways. Thank you in advance for your help. Kindest to regards, Taryn. Let's look at the pictures that Taryn has sent to me, us, whatever. and in this picture you see that your bow hand, Taryn, looks very tensed. Your pinky is straight and not round. You probably hold this same position and not move your wrist or fingers while bowing. What I think is that you can work a lot on bow hold movement and relaxation or splash of your bowing, because this is something every beginner needs to work on. Every beginner, certainly adults, are doing too much with too much strength, with too much one hold, and yeah, too stiff. And then you really hurt yourself because bow hold is really a strange position. If you do that very tensed, then even healthy people get strained in their muscles. And certainly with arthritis or fibromyalgia, you should really watch that you play really relaxed, that you train yourself on the movement of your bow and not on holding a certain position with a lot of strength, because that will really hurt you. Well, Taryn talks about his wrist. Well, what I see is that he pivots his bow to the wrong side. So if you are pivoting your bow, you should pivot your bow to scroll. If you're doing it like this, you are collapsing your wrist and you use muscles that you shouldn't use in that way for bowing. Then also don't hold your bow the whole time in the same hold. It's bow hold is actually a term that I don't like, because it's actually bow movement. So you should have your fingers and wrist as a suspension system. If you do this, and this is a really relaxed movement, I'm not doing any effort for this, then your tone will be better, your bowing will be more smooth, or also if you are suffering from something like arthritis or fibromyalgia, it's possible with these things to play the violin, because playing the violin shouldn't cost a lot of effort. But you really need to do right and relaxed and very fluently to be able to do this. I compare it also with kind of a swimming jellyfish, so you can practice this maybe a little bit. It's a really relaxed and fluent movement. This is actually something you do while bowing, and I think this will definitely help you, certainly as for all beginners, but certainly people who have something on their muscles that it's extra challenging. I wish you all luck with that. And I'm sure that in many cases people, despite of diseases, can learn to play the violin. Even if you can play it just 10 minutes in a row, you can have a lot of fun with it. So I wish you all the luck of the world. And thanks all for watching. And hope to see you in another video. Bye!